Hey, folks. So, just a quickie from me today. I'm gonna talk about how to clean an LCD properly, because I've seen quite a few posts on the Gameboy subreddit, people who've doused their screens in isopropyl alcohol and found out the hard way that will ruin your screen. So I've got here a few of these IPS LCD screens that, despite how they look, they are mostly perfectly functional. If we plug this into my test rig here, you can see it does work. It's a little bit worse for the wear, and I've got an issue in the top right corner with the polarizer lifting off. And this is fixable, but I don't think I can fix it without making it significantly worse. But there's two layers here. There's a coating on the screen and then the polarizer itself, and you can see the polarizer is what's lifting. But long story short, these LCDs are salvaged from Game Boy Advance SP kits, and despite this lifted corner, they'll still work perfectly fine in Game Boy Color kits because you don't see that part of the screen. But what's going on is I have a whole stack of these Game Boy Advance SP LCDs that were sent to me because the lenses themselves are damaged. And these ones are all, they've just got little chips in the corner. I'm actually going to leave these ones as is and probably just throw them in SP mods that I do. Because these screens are still perfectly fine. But, oops, that's. So these are some of the lenses that I pulled off. You can see I started with the ones that were significantly worse. And this first one that I did, stuck all the way at the bottom, you can see here there's quite a bit of polarizer stuck to the lens itself. So that's why my screens look like they're in such garbage condition. But anyway, I want to talk about the, sorry for that tangent there. I want to talk about the proper way to clean these because a lot of people don't seem to know. So my method for cleaning screens, presumably your screen is not nearly as bad as this. You know, you've just got fingerprints all over it, maybe a little bit of adhesive, but nothing crazy like this. My method is, oh, what do I do with it? All right, I have a spray bottle of this goof off stuff. Goo Gone is basically the same thing. I just put a little bit onto a microfiber cloth, just like that. Let that kind of soak in. We do not ever want to spray directly on the screen. It is perfectly fine to get this stuff on the screen, you just do not want to spray it on the screen. The reason for that is it can and will drip into the LCD. Now, a little bit concerned because this is a lot more stuff than I want to use. It's probably fine, so I'm just going to rub it around, make sure it gets on all the adhesive spots, and then I'm going to switch to a clean spot, or at least a not wet spot of my microfiber cloth to actually scrub this. And now I'm just going to sit here and rub it until all the adhesive comes off and goes onto my cloth here. I may need to re-wet this adhesive at some point. The Goo Gone should break it down nicely. And at this stage in the cleaning, we're just worried about getting all the adhesive off. We don't care about actually making the screen look good. All right, now I'm going to switch to another part of my cloth entirely. Start wiping up all the goo gone, or goof off, or whatever the hell I'm using. I don't even know. All right, now I'm going to switch to yet another part of my cloth and use some generic window cleaner that I have. I swear this is, it's not as generic as it looks. This bottle is like half full of generic and half full of Windex, only because I had a bottle of Windex and a bottle of generic and just combined them. But anyway, we're gonna do the same thing as we did on the first step. Spread that on and then switch to yet another spot and wipe it off. And if all goes well, it should start looking pretty darn good. So this is why we want to switch to another spot on the microfiber cloth, because I'm getting these little spots of adhesive that are stuck to the cloth that get reapplied to the screen. So it's kind of important to have at least two different cloths for this, or to try and keep in mind which cloth you use for what, or what part of the cloth. All right, so that's all nice and clean. These microfiber cloths are just like a super cheap pack that I got on AliExpress. And then I have an actual set of like car cleaning microfiber cloths. This is the stuff that you would use on if you wash your car and you want that perfect mirror wax finish. This is what I'm gonna finish with. Just gonna wipe it down. No cleaner. No goof off, no Windex, no isopropyl. And I'm assuming this is not the best way to clean these screens, because quite frankly, this is the second time I've ever really done this. Just decided to film it to try and help people out. So if there's any experts, feel free to chime in here. But the main thing I wanted to highlight was that you never ever apply any liquid to the actual screen itself. You want to apply it to a cloth and make sure that it's not like, you know, dripping wet, and then you can wipe it on the screen. And look at that. Looks pretty good, I think, aside from the corners that I fucked up, but that's besides the point. Let's go ahead and plug this screen in and check out how it looks. Make sure I didn't drip any liquid in there and ruin the layers. And there we go. Looks good to me. So yeah, this one, unfortunately, the corner I cut off a little bit too much, so if I were to put this into a Game Boy Advance, you would see that. But, I mean, it looks pretty good otherwise. It should still be completely fine in a Game Boy Color, though. If we check this out, there's quite a bit of corner that is unused. And if you're paying attention, it was probably glitching just because I keep handling this thing. This thing is all beat to hell, the ribbon's all creased, but it works, so I use it for testing. And there we go. I've got two down now, and I have two down. I was just trying to clean these up because I was planning on putting them away and stacking them, and I didn't want them to stick together. But I have two more to clean. This one is going to be the interesting one, because I think I'm going to play with putting a new polarizer on this one, on account of me totally fucking that up. But I think that'll be for a different video. And I don't even have to bother cleaning this, because if I'm pulling the polarizer off, well, no point. But anyway, yeah, thanks for watching. I hope this helps someone not completely ruin their screen. Otherwise, if you have any questions or comments or anything really, hit me up in the comments. Thanks for watching.